guys, welcome back to another episode of Spazcraft here. Sorry for the few days of delay. I was on a little vacation with a girlfriend to travel to the Tax Slayer Bowl, Penn State versus University of Georgia. It was a wonderful time. It was an unfortunate loss for Penn State and our coach's inability to make play calls, but that is beside the point. It was a lovely trip down to Florida. Unfortunately, it was kind of yucky weather. Definitely not the 80 degrees they've had all December. But it was a nice trip. I was gone for a couple days, had a nice break back in town, and having a couple days off before I have to start getting ready for a trip to New Orleans for a week for a conference, and then back to school for a whole nother semester of meteorology. So we'll have a few days here of videos, and I got a few projects I'd hopefully like to work on and be able to complete. I'm not going to really be able to do much Spazcraft when I'm gone at my conference, because I'll be at a hotel and out of town, but I have a series I think I'm going to go ahead and record ahead of time and load that up over the week. It's a series I've done in the past, but we've got a new map, and I'm probably going to go ahead and do that, so you'll have something to watch that week before I get back to my apartment back at school and can record some Spazcraft. So quick little channel update on that. This episode, I know I wanted to do something else, but nobody else was able to get on tonight. I wanted to build it with them. So we're going to look at a few things the other people built, and then we're going to get to work on, I think, an automatic farm. We're going to add two more to them. They're going to be really, really slow to work, and I'll talk more about them when we get down there, but it's going to add two more small ones that are going to probably be temporarily to see how they work, because I'd really like to test it out. I'm thinking that I'm going to have to do some reading up, because I saw really only one good tutorial for 1.8, and I kind of have it in my head how I could potentially work and make it more. But we'll have to see how that goes. They're going to go probably right in there underground, because they're not going to be very tall, because I think because of how it works with the spawning, I'm not really going to be able to build them too tall. I kind of can only have one individual small stations of each one for how it kind of works in 1.8. But I will have to read up on that myself before I fully decide on that design. I've got all the gear ready to go build that and work on that. It shouldn't take too many more resources because it won't be so stacked up. But we'll a little bit of clearing out. And I think it's going to be tied on a circuit regardless. And I think I'm going to use the same clock, which I think I'm going to extend the life of it to make it not clear out as much. Because this two farms that we're going to build here really need to be pushed much less because it has such a slow growth rate. A really slow growth rate. So Zerzik's been hard coding away, so I don't think he's done too much around here. I know Thalia for sure hasn't been on, so she was with me recently. But I know Necker has built some of his house up there, worked a little bit on the bridges, and I believe Skadum has finished his path up to his house. We can go run up there to see what he's been working on. Davis's place as well. We got a couple things to look at and a project that Skadum has been working on. So we'll go ahead and take a little fly over there. It looks like the path starts down there, so we will. We might as well start up here. Yeah, it looks like it starts here. He splits it off this direction. Oh, he hasn't quite finished it. He's cleared it out, but he's still working on it a little bit. We'll go ahead and he's lit all up. There's this project down there he's been working on. It's really turning out well. I don't know what that is. Why is there slime blocks over there? I'm just going to show you the outside of what he's doing, but he's got it blocked off for construction, and I don't want to spoil it. He's kind of got a little wall up there, so we don't spoil it in our video. Since if you want to see it, go check out his video of him building it, and we'll get to see it when it's fully completed, which will probably be a little while. But he's got this going here pretty decent. Hasn't done too much with the bridges. But wow, this terrain is huge. I didn't realize how this big... Oh, wow, there's a really big flat plateau area up here. I didn't really notice. That's kind of cool. Keep that in mind for building the project. He might just have these powered on, but something told me he had this set up to turn on at night. And maybe he doesn't have it wired down here, but he wanted his whole base to light up. Of course, there's that nether portal, that dreaded nether portal. That he was going to have these all turn on at night, but it's daytime right now, so not sure why that would be the case. Sent a little bit of building in here. You know, nothing special. This is down into a storage room. Of course, now everyone's got ender chests, which is really nice for me to get to my stuff. Achievements. Not sure what that's about. He also worked on an auto-skiller for the skeleton farm, so I'm also going to travel down there to take a look at that. And... Yeah, let's go ahead and climb up to Necker's. And he does have a skeleton horse as well, whether it's the one from down there or something else he got. He does have one himself. He brought his up here, though, but he can run his up along the path because he's made it accessible, while the rest of my path is not. But regardless, we have decided we do want to build a stable, and we found a pretty good design for one. And that'll probably be the next group project. Maybe we'll get everyone on. If not, it'll be either Xerthic or Idavis or Skadim. Or Necker, could be any of them, really. So we saw all the kind of that. Let's see. I guess we got to keep going up a bit more. No, we don't. We have to go over here to get to Necker's. Yes. He started work on this. Oh, yeah. He's done a lot more work. Really starting to build up on this island. It's pretty cool. It looks like he's got one of Gur's heads, too. Speaking of which, I totally forgot about the heads. I totally forgot that I didn't have that working. And I forgot to test that. That'll be something I just got so frustrated with that I forgot about. Spent so much time on. Couldn't get it to work and got pretty upset there. But yeah, he's done a little bit more work on his house here. Let's see. What else has he got? Anything good? He's got some stuff. Oh, this room down here is new. He's smelting. Oh yeah, here's the balcony that overlooks. So this is the new little section where he has the room to smelt. Some more junk. So he's got this nicely. I like to show off some of the stuff that the people that do not have YouTube channels are doing. Because of course you can see Skadim's work and what he's doing. I don't want to spoil too much of what he's doing to go watch, so you can go watch his videos. But we'll go see what some of the others are. Actually, let's see. I guess. Yeah, see, I think like those down there turn on at night, but those don't seem to do that. They seem to be always on. Everyone's looking good. Yeah, so we've got the stable we're going to be building soon. We have the villager breeder we're going to be building soon, which probably have to get some villagers up there or somewhere down here and then take them in a minecart down somehow. Let's now go take a look at... That way stop him from taking wall damage. It gets really glitchy to fall with the Elytra on. This is Idavis's. He does have a YouTube channel. I think you can just Google Idavis on YouTube. I don't think he started recording anything just yet. Just some of the basics in here. Okay, we're not permitted, so we're not going to go in there. But it looks like he's picked a place to live, which is kind of cool. So we're going to go ahead over here now. Because I want to see what the slime blocks up here are for. Because he has a ton of slime blocks. So I wonder if he took those out from down in there. Because he said, oh, I'm going to take like several stacks of slimes. I was like, oh, that's okay. And then I saw that there was still a lot in there. So I just don't know if he hadn't taken them yet. Or if in fact... Oh, geez. What is wrong with this terrain? There's lots of mushrooms here. And I think, because I realized what I'm going to make the title of this video, you're going to know what I'm doing. And these mushrooms are really spreading up here. Oh, I think... That's the nether portal. If you fall out of the nether portal, you can jump down that way. Ah, crap. Oh, jeez. Oh, God. It's getting night. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the nether portal, come out at Skadim's, and then we'll jump down and see what it's like to go on a later down on that panel and see if it can really be useful. He does have the cool base because he built on all these arches, but... I guess I can show this real quick. This is a project. It's going to be a dye factory. I'll leave that alone as it's not completed. And... Yeah, we've done a little bit of landscaping down here, but I think you've seen that. Maybe he already had that skeleton horse because there's one sitting there and another sitting there, so... Unless he stole Gurs, which I doubt he would do. I see one in there. And then I see mine in the other room. Yeah, so ours are both there. He must have just had that, and I just didn't know that he got that from a separate occurrence. Where's the nether portal? Here's the nether portal. And of course, we don't come out at his. Of course, now this is going to become a thing. Ugh. Guess we'll try the other side of it, because that's supposed to work. Yeah, the ideal way to just to fall on slime blocks is not that good. If you have it set up where as you fall, and as soon as you... Oh yeah, here we go. You have it where you fall. Oh, yeah, whoa. He put some there. That's kind of annoying. He could have just took out that whole side, because these over here are, like, all pointless. Yeah, I guess you can just fly with the elytra off them. If you have it where it launches you up as you do it, it's going to be much higher bounce. But this really just to stop you from dying, so. Okay. How are these coming down here? So these are still working on filling up. I don't have to worry about that. Okay. So I think where these are going to go is I can put them underground. So I think I'm going to put them in this wall here and then put this, like, staircase somewhere else. Because I think I'm going to put them, like, right here, because they might be built up a little bit at some point, but they might not be. And if they will, it won't be too high. So I think I'm going to work right behind this wall, and we'll have, like, one right there. I think it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3. Oh, wow, that's, like, almost perfect with each chest here. And, of course, we can always move things around. So I think that's where we're going to do that. We're, of course, going to be making a brown mushroom and red mushroom automatic farm. Now, mushrooms are a little bit finicky, so you could have a timer that has, like, a light level that turns on to pop them off, but we are going to use mycelium, because mushrooms just, it's just easier to use that, because it helps keep their growth controlled. So they can be really bright and still grow on mycelium. So instead we're going to use, instead of using water and risking, like, popping a bunch off, because I had one idea of basically, like, you used to do it in the old days. So you have row of mushrooms on, like, either side, and then a trench in the middle, and then they would grow down in the dark onto the stone. And then you could have the water either by triggering it, which I don't want to do. We want to make it automatic. By just basically on a clock, you could have the water flow down and then pick itself right back up after. But I was like, I'll just have them popped off by a piston, just like we did the rest of it. We'll test it out. I found a good design. It seems like somewhat useful, but I'm not too sure on the productivity. Now, some of you may say, just grow the big mushrooms. Yeah, well, if I'm going to grow the big mushrooms, I'm probably just because if you need lots of them. But the point is to have it to be automated. It's so much better when it's automated. Just over time, you accumulate mushrooms and you don't even know it. You don't have to do any work at all. And if I do grow the big mushrooms or go to the Mushroom Island and destroy the big ones, I want to do it with Silk Touch so that I have building blocks. And would probably rather do that way than grow it for actual mushrooms. So I'm going to clear out a little room in here, hook it up to this redstone circuit, build a little contraption. I'll show you what I'm doing, and we'll see if we can get it to work. I'm going to read a bit up on the mushrooms, and I'll provide a little bit of more information about how they spawn, the slow growth rates, and how we're going to make this work. So mushrooms are very, very difficult to farm, and they've gotten much more difficult to farm into the later versions. Basically, they have like a 1% chance of getting the opportunity to spawn every tick of the game. And it looks like on average, it's about every half hour does a mushroom actually spawn another one. And they can spawn in a pretty far radius. You know, they can spawn a couple blocks out in like all three dimensions diagonally around two different blocks in the region. Now, what the mushrooms will do is, from the center mushroom in like a 9 by 9 by 3 cube, which is pretty big region here, if there is more than 5 of that one type of mushroom, for instance, there is 5 red mushrooms in a 9 by 9 by 3 area, it will not spawn any more of them. So if it did happen to spawn like a red mushroom here and then it got like down the row, or it spawned like every 2 and they jumped, this one over here might not see the couple over there, so then it can start spawning more and it can still continue to spread, but in a small localized area like a farm, that is not going to be the case. And the one design I had 4 mushrooms that were trying to spawn on 2 locations, which was pretty high, but if one of those does spawn, it's not going to spawn on the other one. And that also makes it very difficult to stack the farm as well, because it's going to be in that 9 by 9 by 3. So I would have to, like, alternate where it would be, literally be, like, red, brown, red, brown might work. That would be 3. But then over to the left, it would just be really tricky with how I had to do it. But I could stack and probably have to alternate, which would make it a pain in the butt for collecting the mushrooms down at the bottom. So for now, I'm going to build one stall, like, in the middle of the ground right here. One for red, one for brown for now. And I'm going to use those to collect down into chests, and we'll see how slow it is, if it even works. If we're just getting 1 or 2 mushrooms, we'll just let it go for a week or two on the server and see where things go from there. And if alternating, it will grow and raise rates. And if by having 4 mushrooms here, if I just put it down to 2, and that way I can kind of stack things better and not worry about that rate going up, having 2 trying to spawn on 2 might also be a possible opportunity because if having four doesn't really increase it too much. But this, people say this one farm design works, and I'm going to try it. It was the same guy that designed a couple of our other farms, I think, including... No, we didn't use his. His was too complicated. Maybe the Blaze farm. He did the Blaze farm design, so... it's going to definitely be worth a try. So I've about cleared out the area that I'm going to use, and it shouldn't be too... It's really not that difficult of a design as well, because it's just a small place. So I'm going to get to work, and I'm just going to show you guys at the end. Of course, a link to this tutorial done by this guy will be down in the description if I remember to put it there, which I should. You can go check it out if you want to use it in your world as well, or to see it, look at the design fully, and then let me know if there's any modifications I could make to make it better, because I'm not the best Minecraft... designer here when it comes to mushroom farms. I've made one or two mushroom farms in my time, and they were all dark rooms, and they were back in the old days where you could use mushroom stew for food because it was useful, because, you know, pork chops would keep one, but you could have one bowl and two stacks of each type of mushroom, and you could have a lot more food and a smaller amount of space in your inventory versus carrying all these pork chops, and because it healed up four. Now mushroom stew is pretty pointless, but if you need mushrooms, I've always just grown them. And that's about it. And this farm's really growing pretty quick. I just saw both of those pop up. So, all right, to work. It looks like our animals up here have been doing well, and our slime farm as well. There were several stacks of slime in there, and I think it's because, like, when people are just hanging out really anywhere here, especially here, I think it still loads in the spawns. I mean, because it's anywhere from like 32 to 128 blocks away from the player, the slime spawns. So it seems to be working despite. No one actually AFKing down there, you know, working just enough, you know, just happening to build and spawn, especially if we expand it maybe this direction a little bit or one of the chunks over here, that despite all those, like, slime blocks skate and built, there was still plenty in there for me to take to make some sticky pistons. So, as you can see here, this is going to be one of the little rooms here, and the next one will be right next to it, that's brown. These are the four spawning platforms, and basically these are the only two blocks I want it to be able to grow on. I assume this guy's found out basically how efficient it is, and maybe it's something I'll tweet it to soon and be like, hey, automated mushroom farm, or mushroom myth busting. To see if he's done any of that, because I don't think he's done that, and maybe an idea for him to do, because he likes to really test this stuff out. But these two, we're going to have to work the efficiency of it. I'm going to build it exactly like this guy did first, and then we'll see if it goes ahead and works. But these two fit in here quite nicely, and they have the potential to be stackable depending on the rules of the building, of whatever you call it. I always build these backwards. Always, always, always build these backwards. We only need two for right now. Actually, we're going to need four in the long run, so we might as well make all four now. There we go. There we go. Grab that. And then these will be the sticky piston blocks that extend to push basically these out and to push it this direction. And, of course, I'm going to be enclosing this all in so the blocks don't go flying, and to prevent these from spreading elsewhere, because if these blocks are dark, I think it can spread elsewhere. So either placing slabs or lighting it up, I will be able to prevent that. So I'm going to get to the rest of this behind this now, because I need to look at the video to remember how to wire this up to down below, because I'm going to bring it from over there. Well, this project was fairly easy. It was about a 20-minute ordeal, and I finished two, one for the brown. Oh, and look at this! This literally just happened within the last 2 minutes of me going to pause my music to start recording. And look at this, we have a brown mushroom growing. So we know that this process works. I'm waiting for the contraption to fire to see if I've redstone wired this up correctly, so that when the redstone clock on the other side ticks, that and all of the pistons fire, we'll see if all four of these fire and this gets popped off and collected. Oh, and they all four fired, and it popped off, and let's see if it got collected down there, because if it did that, it's fantastic, because then I'm just going to, like, wall this in, close all of this off. I'm going to show you what's back here. Very, very simple redstone setup, and this is just wired down here to this whole setup. I just decided, instead of, like, powering it up, which is what he did from a clock underneath, I just went ahead and direct wired this. I ended up not needing to clear out all this space in here because I realized I wanted to move it up so that it can flow into the double chest. It's the same setup as we had in the others. I've tried to light this up as much as possible, so hopefully no mushrooms can spawn down here. I'm not going to fill it in at the moment because I'm not sure how I'll expand this up in the future, because we might have a water collection system. I'm not quite sure how that's going to happen, but I'm going to probably at least cover this, enclose these, but leave some of this other stuff undone. So you can see it's a pretty basic setup here. And then down here, I've got it just like all of the others, where they flow down into the chest from those three hoppers there and get collected. You can see, let me make sure there's nothing in these. And then nothing in these. And there, if this worked, there'll be a brown mushroom down here. And there is! As long as we see that the red one works as well, this works. It's worked beautifully. One in, you know, the couple minutes we've been here. So it's a pretty slow growth rate. As you know, it's like one mushroom per 30 minutes. Each of these can spawn. And again, I'm pretty sure that once one mushroom does spawn, another mushroom will not be able to spawn next to it because it's less than five, not five. So I'm sacrificing some of the growth rate there. But the four really increases the chances of something else growing, because if you just had one or two, I mean, I just feel like it would just be such a low chance. You want to maximize your chances of something growing because you're going to be harvesting so regularly. Now, I want to go see if we can get over there. Whoops. My light just glitching out. What the clock set timer is on, because I wouldn't mind extending it, because the sugar cane, well, the cacti is not on one, and the sugar cane can grow a second one up if it hasn't been harvested, and I've seen that happen already on this time of clock, but you know, whatever, it happens so few. And these, they're overproducing so much that if we just wait and let some more grow, I wouldn't be too worried about that. But let's see if we can. Why does sugarcane get in here? It must, like, glitch out. You know what? I bet you it glitches out the back wall and then gets collected down here, which is kind of bizarre. I bet I can do this. Okay, so there is, like, you know, we're going to add just an extra stack in there. 32. Yeah, so that's like four and. It's like four and a half stacks. Well, let's see. If that's going to be one stack, two, three. Yeah, there's like four stacks in there. So we'll leave it at four for now. I may extend it as time goes on. But that is turned out to be four. So that'll slow this whole thing down a little bit, which is shouldn't be too much of an issue, especially now that we've got this contraption back here and other resources I've really stockpiled up beautifully. So I'm going to go ahead and fill this in, and we'll go ahead and finalize this project. Well, the mushroom farm is now complete. Of course, we'll have to do some measurements, see if it's stackable. And maybe I will actually try and reach out to Asuma and see if he'll respond to anything I reach out to him about mushroom farming. But we'll have to work something out with this, and we'll be working on the paths and all that good stuff. But that's another project down the books. This was kind of a spontaneous thing I ended up doing tonight, so we'll see how well that works with just the two of those coming out. This is going to get torn down because this is all becoming part of his there. So we'll tear this down, and I'll probably work on some more paths. And over there is where I'm going to build the stable, so that'll hopefully be one of the next episodes. And I'm excited to work on that. One thing I noticed is that these top layers just never grew. And I remember that at the start, and I thought I had fixed that. Oh, notice that those have turned to grass. I thought I'd fixed that by putting dirt here at the top, and it seemed like it was starting to make them grow, but then they stopped. And I was like, maybe it's because I covered it, but this one's still exposed, and they're lit up in there. They're water. I'm not sure why they are not growing like the other ones are. They're, it's the exact same. I mean, the roofs, the walls, the sides are the exact same. So really bizarre. If anybody knows why those might not be growing and what I could possibly do to fix that, because it's kind of silly to have that top layer and have it not work like that. Look at the grass. It's spreading down, down on the inside there. So maybe I'll remove the tops and let them grow and see what happens. But it's really kind of weird. So, and I also noticed that this maybe I should put down as cobble, because I kind of like how that would be cobble to kind of match, and, you know, I gotta work on this. This is so ugly. And me failing at the elytra. So yeah, it's all working. It's all set up and good to go. Waiting to see one red one in there. I'll leave my character AFK for a little bit this evening. And we have a lot of feathers. So everything's coming together really nicely here. Oh, and that one's full. I'm almost onto the third chest. So I think that is going to be it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching me build another automated item. Again, the video link is down in the description. Likely a little bit of off-screen work, and we're going to get ready to build this contraption. Or not the contraption. It's really just going to be a chill build for these little guys, because we need something to store them in down in this amplified terrain, because really their only use is going to be either tunnels or into the nether, and it's really going to be for the nether tunnels, because on land, horses not too efficient here. So thank you guys so much for watching. My elytra's shiny. I forgot that would happen when I made it. My character seems so dark as well. That's strange. Why does he get so dark? It's like I'm not standing on or anything, am I? I don't think so. Well, anyway, if you like this video and have liked the series so far, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, share this with your friends. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. See ya. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to check out some more Minecraft, why not check out my Sky Factory 2 Let's Play with Xerthic and Necker by clicking here in the top left. If you'd like to see something else, you can check out my Eidolon Let's Play that I'll be finishing this summer by clicking here in the top right. You can follow me on Twitter down below, and then if you'd like what you've seen so far and you have yet to subscribe, click the big banner below.